yesterday we solved the technique to solve the circuit. Today again we are here to solve this circuit, and we will see at the end what result we are getting. Okay. So first of all, when you see any circuit, you start by giving the initial states the same. Suppose that initially it is in size zero state. Okay. Initially it is in size zero state, and after applying U3 gate on the first qubit line and X gate on the second qubit line, here we reaches in the psi 1 state. Okay, and after this U3 operations, you reach in psi 2 state, and so on. Basically, you can divide your states on the basis of solving of these gates, and each time slices, we can just give the name. We can solve the states by our calculation. So first of all, we saw that it's U3 gate in the first line and X gate on the second line. Okay. So what is U3 gate? U3 gate has got three parameters, that is theta, phi, and lambda. Suppose we take U3 as theta, we take as pi by 2, phi we take as pi by 2, lambda as we take as pi by 2. So what will be the value of U3? U3 gate has the value U3 gate.
Line
and doing the calculation, we will get psi 1 gate. So what is the psi 1 state? So what is the psi 1 state? Here, psi 1 state is nothing but it's U3 applying on 0, it's this thing. So, and the second qubit line it's get 1, okay? So it's get 1 on the second, and on the third it's 0, okay? So till here our calibration is this thing, okay? So psi 1 state is this thing, okay? Psi 1 is 1 by root 2 of 0, 1, 0 plus iota times 1, 1, 0, okay? So psi 1 state, we get this thing, okay? And you can see whether it is normalized or not by taking the modulus square and adding on the addition of the square of the modulus, and if it's 1, it's normalized, okay? So now for getting the psi 2 state, see here, the psi 2 state is this thing, okay? It means after applying this control U3 gate on this psi 1, we will get psi 2 gate. So for getting the psi 2 gate, or a psi 2 state, sorry. Yes?
I have a question.
Yes,
you can write psi 1 equals to some operation on psi 0.
Yes.
Psi 1 equals to some operation on psi 0.
Yes.
Write in that form.
So, at that format, you are saying that it means that, when we will write psi 2 will be here. Control U3 or psi 1.
Yes, you will write it as
CC of U3 on psi 1. That's what you are saying.
Yeah. This is completely perfect for psi 2.
Psi 2, yes.
Write this for psi 1.
Psi 1, okay. So psi 1 it will be, So psi 1 it will be, psi 1 will be, psi 1 will be what? U3 on 0, U3 on, it will be U3x and U3x and identity on 0, 0, 0. This will be psi 1. Actually, it's not 0, 0, it's psi 0. I mean, it's this thing. Psi 0. Which is nothing but.
What is the x thing?
U3, now it's x. U3, x, identity on 0, 0, 0.
So you mean first I applies on 0, 0, 0, then x applies on whatever comes, and then U3 applies on whatever comes?
No. It's that U3 will be for this 0, x will be for this 0, and I will be for this 0.
How do I know that?
How? You can do, this is for the first, when it is written in this fashion, actually this 0, 0, 0, it's written in this fashion. 0 for this, and this 0 for this, and 0 for this. Actually you are right. U3, x and I, it's actually nothing but 0 tensorial of 0 tensorial of 0, which means U3 on 0 tensorial of identity on 0 tensorial of x on 0 tensorial of I of 0. It's this point.
The way you have written it, U3x I on 0,
U3x.
Then tensored with 0, then tensored.
No, here it's not.
Yeah.
Yes, it should be like, if you are writing it as U3x I, it should be like this, okay?
That would, you know what that would mean, if you just write that. That would mean that on 0 you are applying I, then x, then U3, and then you are taking the entire tensor product with 0, again tensor product with another 0. Are you trying to say that?
No, I am saying that if you
your writing should always reflect what you want to say.
It should be like this, okay? Directly, if U3x and I, it's 0, 0, 0, so it will be U3 0 tensorial of x of 0 tensorial of I of 0.
Write the previous step. It would mean this.
So from here you can write here.
No.
Huh?
So 3x and I means what?
U3
is a 2 plus 2 matrix.
U3 is a 2 plus 2 matrix.
X is also 2 plus 2 matrix.
Yes.
So I would mean that it is normal matrix multiplication.
Okay. You can.
Since you are describing a circuit's computation,
yes,
you should be very consistent with the mathematics, at least the basic mathematics.
So U3x and I of 0, 0, 0 will give us U3 0 tensorial with x of 0 and I of tensorial.
Okay. So let's not put your lag mode. Just like you put your qubits as tensor products to separate which is first system, second system, third system, your operators needs to be also put in this particular fashion. So U3 tensor product x tensor product I.
Of x tensor product of I.
I then operating on.
Non operating on
0, 0, 0.
Okay.
What is the right side? Okay. This is how you should write. Okay. Done, of course.
Okay. So here it is in this fashion. U3. So this. No. Now you are clear that psi 1 is. So psi 1 is. This thing U3x and I on psi 0, okay? And so for psi 2 we have done this, C U3 of psi 1, okay? So psi 2 is nothing but C C U3 of psi 1. So C C U3 of psi C C U3 of psi 1, okay? So what was our psi 1? Psi 1 is our this thing. U3x and I of 0, 0, 0.
We have written it already, psi 1.
Yes, where was psi 1?
Just above.
No, this is psi 1, nah? This is psi 1.
Yeah.
This is psi 1 and CCU3 of psi 1. Okay. So now CCU3 of psi 1 will be? CCU3 of psi 1 will be? Yes. Control on first, control on second, and then U3 on third. Okay, psi 1. Okay. So it's written as this. Now, when the first qubit, it will only this do two controls will work only when we will get the first two qubit as 1. Then only this will work. This control control U3. Here we are getting that this C1 is 0 and C2 is 1. So it will not work. It will only work in this case where both of the controls are 1. So applying CCU3 will only work on upon the this second term of the psi 1. Okay. So
second
the second term of
second term.
U3. This CCU3 will work upon only the second term of the psi 1. That's what I'm saying.
Look there.
Yes.
U3 is operated on the
this,
third
this,
qubit.
This control control U3, okay.
So the U3 is operated on the third qubit, right?
Yes.
And so why are we telling second qubit?
No, I am saying this control control U3, this, the whole, this gate, you take it as 1. This will work on the second term of the psi 1. Because.
So that is second? Yeah.
Because the first term of the psi 1, here both the first and the second term is not 1. Will only work when the both of the first two qubits are over. Okay,
yeah.
That's what I'm saying. So control control U3 on psi 1. So it will go up only in this case. Okay, that is control control U3. So what's our U3 for this parameter was this thing. Okay, now it will work only for this thing. Okay, that is control control U3. Okay, so now U3 will work. Now applying this on this, okay, which will be nothing but 1 1 0, matlab U3 will act upon this 0, okay, that is U3 act on 0 is 1 by root 2 of U3 act on 0 will be given 1 by root 2 1 I, okay. So we will write that for this when U3 will apply on this 0, it will give us this thing 1 by root 2 of 1 and I, okay. By root 2 of
0 1 0
plus I
1 1
then 0, then we have 0, and for U3 acting on 0 for that parameter was 1 by root 2 of 1 iota.
Hold on.
Again?
Yes.
Your first two qubits are in ket representation. And your third qubit is
a matrix. Is a matrix. So it is just we should write it all in matrix.
You have to write everything in matrix.
Yes, yes.
Why don't you write that thing in ket form?
Yes, I should write it. But it's a if it's 0, 1, 0, and if it's iota, so it's a 1. 1 and for this 1 by root 2 1 iota it will be 1 by root 2 of ket 0 plus iota ket 1. Okay? So simply we can write here when you 3 apply on this 0 it will give you plus. It is 1 by root 2 of ket 0 plus iota ket 1. Okay? So psi 2 till here. We have performed our operations and we have reached this state. Further proceeding,
be very careful with your amplitude. The
yes.
1 by root 2 will not tell you.
Yeah, yeah, okay. But more or less, we have checked everything out, so I am pretty sure that it's normalized. There for U3 for that parameter it was for U3 of pi by 2 and pi by 2 you also again you will have this U3 what it was 1 by root 2
1 minus
a 1 minus
I
1 okay
I minus
yeah minus 1 U3 for this parameter. So psi 2 we are getting this. Here? Yeah. Get this. Now after psi 2, we are getting this. It's actually U3 on the second qubit and control is on the third qubit. This means this operation will this gate will perform its operation on this only when we have the control that is the third qubit in one state, k one state. So what we are seeing here that's a 0, 1, 0 and first term is it will not perform on the first term because the third is 0, okay? And here it is 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1 iota 1. So it will only perform in this last control U3. And it will not perform its operation on the second and in this first. Okay, so we will get our term as you come here. Okay, so we will get our term as 1 by root 2 and it's 0, 1, 0 plus iota of iota upon root 2 iota upon root 2 of 1, 1, 0 plus, no, it's not plus, iota square is minus. So it's minus of 1 upon root 2 and it's in the ket form which is 1, 1, 1. 1, 1, 1, okay? Now this 1, 1, 1, for this last term which we have 1, 1, 1, the third, for this 1, 1, 1, we have this control term for this as 1. So this U3 will act upon only this term only when on this second okay. So here U3 on 1. So U3 on 1 will give us get 1. U3 is just 1 by root 2 of 1 minus iota minus 1 and work at 1 is 0, 1. So it's a 2 cross 2 matrix, it's a 2 cross 1 matrix. So finally we are getting 2 cross 1 matrix. And for this it's a 0 and it's minus iota. And it's 0 and minus 1. So it's minus 1 by root 2 of minus 1 by root 2 of iota of k0 plus k1. So u3 on k1 will give us this thing, okay? So here u3 will apply on k1 because the control term is 1, only this term is active, it will participate only in this. So u3 on 1 will give us 1 upon root 2 as 0, 1, 0 plus iota over root 2 and it's 1, 1, 0 and it's minus 1 upon root 2 and u3 acting on 1 it will give us, u3 acting on the 1 it will give us minus upon 1 upon root 2, that is minus minus plus 1 upon root 2, 1 upon root 2 iota k0 plus k1. Okay, and for this last one we have k1. This is our order till this. So we have reached here, which is psi 3 state. So get the psi 3, that is state psi 3, we have reached here. So we should solve it. We should not make it complex, so we should just solve it and make it 1 by root 2 and it's let's 0, 1, 0 and it's plus iota by root 2 1, 1, 0 plus 1 upon 2, 1 upon 2, so first it's iota
upon root 2, iota upon root 2, add 1 on 1 will give
first we should make this all the root 2 as common. So it will be 1/2. Okay. 1/2 and it will be 0 0 1 0 0 1 0 plus 1 1 0 1 1 0 plus iota times 1 root 2 will be remaining here. We have taken only 1 root 2 out. So iota by root 2 it's 0 1 0. So 0 1 0 0 1 0 minus iota by root 2 minus iota by root 2 minus iota by root 2 1 1 0 1 1 0. Okay, till here we are done, and here it's plus 1/2. Remember we have taken root 2 or root 2 as well. So it's 1/2. It's iota of 0 0 1. Iota of 0 0 1. Iota of 0 0 1. And it's minus of 1 0 1.
1 1 1
minus of 1 1 1.